New Hope was established in 1979 by our founding mother, Edith Palmer, and a group of concerned women and men to address what they saw as the community problem of domestic violence. During its first year in operation, New Hope's 15 volunteers responded to 500 calls. In 2008, New Hope answered 3,653 hotline calls on our domestic violence and sexual assault hotline.
New Hope is important because violence in all kinds of relationships unfortunately exists.
It's just really great to be able to help empower someone, to help someone come from a situation where, you know, they're in crisis, and to give them some stability, some support. It's definitely needed. I see it every day, and it's a rewarding thing.
Working for respect with the batterers intervention has been amazing. It was really an eye-opener to see some of the behaviors that batterers have, and I mean, the majority of them have had violence in their own lives and have been victims.
The challenge of domestic violence is something that seems to be growing.
The fact that we're working to strengthen individuals and families, that it's all-inclusive, it's not just women and children, but we're really looking at the bigger piece of it, that we're looking at women, children, men, we're looking at gay, straight, transgendered. We're really looking at the full community, and it has the biggest impact that way.
By taking a proactive approach to this issue, we believe we are able to take bigger strides towards one day achieving our goal of ending domestic and sexual violence in our community.
I am bewildered by all that I have gone through, all that I have known in these 40 years. I am also in awe of my own strength. I never knew I possessed it. Sometimes I feel as though I am superhuman, as though I am watching someone else perform these feats.
What brought me to New Hope, event-wise, was an assault outside in public. It had always been behind closed doors. It was the first time it happened out on the street.
It was a case of domestic violence that I could not cope with on my own, and I needed assistance, clinical, housing, and shelter and basic.
I think I can bring it to one incident or one feeling, and that was fear. I was afraid.
There are still times when I fight my own demons, the shadow of the past, when I begin to think what's wrong with me, or that I'm not a whole person. I must, at these times, remind myself that I have, and have always had, what I needed inside.
Low point before I came to New Hope was when I was pregnant, driving back and forth to Boston, commuting to work, and all I wanted to do was drive my car into a tree. I didn't know how to make it stop. I didn't know how to get out.
But I knew that something needed to change, and I knew that I couldn't go on any longer the way that I was.
The fact that I had to give up my careers, I had to give up all my schooling. I went from having everything to having absolutely nothing. The shock of that alone was devastating to my life.
The skies are blue, the days are brighter, the nights are peaceful. I am whole, not half a person. My ways are mine.
New Hope didn't just change my situation. They saved three people, my two children and myself.
Giving me a place to go, a place of refuge.
I could have stopped. I could have just self-imploded. But I am a worthwhile person, and I have a lot to offer this world, and I don't want anybody to step on that ever again.
And so that's another high point, just me getting me back. It was a difficult process, but I'm there. I'm better now.
I think since then, the high points have been create a home that's safe and healthy and happy, and that I actually have a future.
every person can improve on themselves. They are unique and a beautiful person, giving of themselves with their own gift to the world. Some leaders, some healers, some learners, workers, speakers, and givers, but all are beautiful. You can't keep me down, but I'll stand back
up. Just looking to a better day, just helping people look to a better day. And that's what New Hope encompasses for me, is that person who walks through the door and you're downtrodden and you're broken and you're going through so much. But hopefully by the time you walk out the door, you're looking up, your day is looking better.
There's always hope for the survivor. There's always hope for the better. It's just that they need to find that hope and they need to act on it.
My hope for New Hope is that, as crazy as this sounds, my hope is that there'll come a day when New Hope is not needed.
When you're born, and as you grow up, you hope for things. You want to do things. You hope you're going to have a nice life. You hope this. And when you're battered down, then you have to have a new hope. I hope.
I hope.
I hope.
I hope.
I hope.
I hope.
I hope.
I hope.
I hope.
I hope.
I hope.
I hope.
I hope.